Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'd like to welcome you here to the wedding of Charles and Aspen. Have a few announcements here. First, we do have an official photographer and videographer here today. So we will ask everybody in attendance if you'll please allow them to do their jobs. They should be able to come up with some nice pictures and videos here of today's ceremony. Also, as soon as the ceremony is concluded, the bride and groom welcome you all back up to the pavilion for refreshments. Just located right up over the hill here. So once again, the ceremony is over. You're welcome to join them up there. At this time, we'll begin the ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we're going to ask that you please stand for the bride. We are gathered here today in the sight of God and in the presence of family, friends, and loved ones to celebrate one of life's greatest moments. We are here to give recognition to the worth and beauty of love and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words that will unite Charles and Aspen in matrimony. Since the beginning of time, people have performed ceremonies to mark a transition, a change of status. Today we gather for the happiest of ceremonies, the change of status from two single individuals to one married couple. Traditionally, that change is indicated by the passing of the bride's hand from her father to her husband-to-be. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
You may all be seated. What a blessing it is to be standing here today to bear witness and celebrate the joining of Charles and Aspen. It has been a wonderful journey for your family and friends to watch the stages of your relationship from all those years ago to the very present, and now becoming man and wife. May today's union and celebration live forever in your hearts and continue until the end of time. Charles and Aspen, marriage is the most important of all earthly relationships. It should be entered into reverently, thoughtfully, and with full understanding of its sacred nature and intent. Your marriage must stand by the strength of your love and the power of faith in each other and in God. Just as two threads woven in opposite directions form a beautiful tapestry, so will your two lives, when they are merged, make a beautiful marriage. A wedding is more than a celebration of the love which lives in Charles and Aspen's heart today. It reaches into the future and proclaims their intentions for that which tomorrow shall hold. A couple who wed are joined not only by the mutual affection and the love that they share, but also by their hopes, dreams, and by their promises of what will be. The promises and vows they make this day shall guide them into their common future. I will now ask you if you are prepared to make these promises. In times of joy and times of sorrow, we seek Scripture to give us strength in our daily walk. Today, I feel it is important to share this with both of you on your wedding day. A reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8, in the New International Version. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy and it does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others and it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. Let today be a testament to all that is, was, and forever will be love. Now I will ask the groom and bride to please repeat after me and take these vows in front of God, your family, and friends. Charles. I, Charles.
I, Charles.
Take you, Aspen.
Take you, Aspen.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and I will cry with you.
I will laugh with you and I will cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I have given you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Now Aspen. I, Aspen.
I, Aspen.
Take you, Charles.
Take you, Charles.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I'll trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I've given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Dear friends, let us continue to love one another, for love comes from God. Anyone who loves is born of God and knows God, but anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love. God showed us how much he loved us by sending his only Son into the world so that we might have eternal life through him. This is real love. It is not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as a sacrifice to take away our sins. Since God loved us that much, we surely ought to love each other. No one has ever seen God, but if we love each other, God lives in us, and his love has been brought to full expression through us. Let today live in our hearts and be a humble reminder that love conquers all. Now the I do's. Charles, do you take Aspen to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only onto her forevermore?
I do.
Aspen, do you take Charles to be your husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only onto him forevermore?
I do.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ring is a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end, no giver and no receiver, for each is the giver and each is the receiver. Traditionally, the passage to the status of husband and wife is marked by the exchange of rings. May these rings always remind you of the vows you have taken. May I have the rings, please? Charles, please take Aspen's ring. Please place the ring on Aspen's finger and repeat after me. I, Charles.
I, Charles.
Take you, Aspen.
Take you, Aspen.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
Her, not me.
To you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I take you as my wife.
I take you as my wife.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
There you go.
And now, Aspen, please place the ring on Charles's finger and repeat after me. I, Aspen.
I, Aspen.
Take you, Charles.
Take you, Charles.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer. Poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
I promise my love to you.
I promise my love to you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I take you as my husband.
I take you as my husband.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Let us join all in prayer, please. Bless their marriage, O God, as they begin their journey down the road of life together. We do not know what lies ahead, for the road turns and bends, but help them to make the best of whatever comes their way. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing nor no one is perfect, and to look for the good in all things and all people, including themselves. Lord, help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes and dreams, and fears, even though they may not always understand them. Help them to learn from each other and to help each other to grow mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Help them to realize that no matter what happens to them, they will hold on to each other and know that things have a way of working out for the good. Help them to continue building a peaceful, stable home of love as a foundation on which they can build their own lives on. But most of all, Holy Father, help them to keep lit the torch of love that they now share so that by their loving example, they may pass on the light of love today, tomorrow, and forever. Amen. You have declared before all of us that you will live together in marriage. You have made special promises to each other, which have been symbolized by the joining of hands, taking of vows, and the giving and receiving of two rings. It is now my privilege and honor to now pronounce you husband and wife. Charles, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, may I be the first to formally introduce to you for the first time, Mr. Charles and Mrs. Aspen Briner.
Thank you.
And again, ladies and gentlemen, you are welcome to join the bride and groom up on the pavilion for cocktails and refreshments. Thank you.